fix this, like our logo is not why is it cut? Is it good?
Like a Oh, thank you so much.
Adjust your adjust.
Is there like something like a dimension?
No. Setup. That's reset. I mean, you can reset. This is the graph.
Is it restarting now?
The graph, yes.
Yeah, also, I was just thinking.
You can grab some food and
drink. Oh, wait, I think I know something.
You know what?
No, it's like a setting on the left. Alright, going into the next demo from the graph. We have Charchit, the community manager in India, and the topic will be Web3 data, AI, and the graph. Charchit, the floor is yours.
Hey guys, how are you?
What?
I hope you are having good time in Denver. So, yeah. Myself, Charchit Kumar. I'm based in India, and like I'm leading the India project for the club. And this, our main topic is Web3 data, AI in the graph. So let's begin. And like here you can see, like in the next coming years, like it is going to be, like the main topic of discussion is going to be around Web3 data and AI, obviously. So you can just observe that. It is predicted by like one of the reputed like survey website named Statistia. So next, since the size of the blockchain adoption is going to take place, so it is expected to be around 39 billion, and right now it's 23 billion. So as our query volume are also started increasing. So like in the 2022 quarter one, like we have around 250. Million queries in that quarter, and now we have almost 1 billion queries in just this quarter of 2023. So like now the main question comes, like why Web3 plus AI, right? So like you may be aware about that the Web3 data possess a good, very good properties, that it's verifiable and you can just access it permissionlessly. And the property of blockchain itself allows you to track and trace where the data is coming from. So that's the added on advantage on the Web3 data. So like if you now just imagine you like train the LLM model over the Web3 data, it will just increase, or it will just introduce a lot more new applications. It will reduce your risk. It will help you in risk management, asset management in DeFi. And for DAO, it helps you to make the governance much easier, and a lot more applications can come up with the AI and the Web3 integration. Yeah. So like, let's dive more into the Web3 data part. So like, the Web3 data is the distributed data and the distributed infrastructure. So like, it's on different chain, different nodes, and it could be accessed from different nodes, and that this single distributed data infrastructure can provides a lot many properties. So from them I mentioned just two, but like I can list down 10 or 15 software. So it helps in enhanced censorship resistance. It improves the transparency and accountability. And apart from these properties of Web3 data, like it has a lot more applications out there. Like in like DeFi, your NFTs, your DAOs, your governance. And like when we talk about developer and developer experience, it will help in tooling, analytics, and a lot more. So now let's discuss in depth what AI algo can bring in Web3. So like an LLM trained over the Web3 data can do a lot more. Like it will with its computational power, it will helps to take much better decision than human beings can do. So when the world is going towards more towards on chain, the AI part should will have a lot more application. So like right now in our Web2, like we have seen like there are many traders who trade using the AI, and like with their Python programming and a lot more, with their different AI algorithms are there, different tools are there. So this part can like increase a lot more potential and a lot more applications over the on-chain world. So the AI can provide smarter insights, more personalized experience. It also provides unbreakable security. So like you can analyze the risk while handling an asset in DeFi market, and risk involving in swapping the tokens out there, like be it any like DEX or like any swapping tool out there. And more further dive into it, so like it will help you for the resource optimization part. Like you can literally, like if you start thinking more about it, you can literally save gas fee. You can just utilize the on-chain data and can calculate the upcoming gas fee over the Ethereum transaction or like any other L1 or L2 out there. Yeah. So let's So now we have talked about Web3 data, AI, and now the main role comes of the graph layer. So in simpler terms, graph makes it easy to fetch blockchain data to your front end using simple GraphQL API. And the main mission and ethos of the graph is to enable full stack decentralization so that your application doesn't disappear anywhere. So like I was reading about a bunch of Web2 startups out there. So in 2018, one of the startups, like one of the media startups, like who has the like only one source of revenue, like which is Facebook page, but like suddenly it got deleted by the Facebook and the American government because of the simple reason that foreign media house influencing American voters. So this is a very big problem in Web2, and like the more we are spending into community and the more we are telling people about the privacy and the ownership part, this becomes much more important to have a full stack decentralization application for a startup. So some of our solutions are, we provide subgraph or the open API, which could be fetched using simple GraphQL, and we have Firehose, which is a tool for like index data from the chain to the Postgres database, and then we have the substream powered subgraph. So like this is our offering of the graph, and this is the like basic diagram of graph node. So like graph, you can just deploy the subgraph over the smart contract. And that subgraph could be like queried using simple GraphQL. So this was pretty much about graph, and let's move forward. And now, like the main question comes, like how we are able to provide these offerings. So like the graph is powered by the graph network, and here we like the coordination takes place between many key stakeholders and many network participants. So that's where the GRT comes in. GRT is a governance token. It just helps to collaborate within the network. Yeah. So our network is supported by mainly three players: indexer, curator, delegator. And this is like developers are main customers over here. So they just do the query fetching part and pay the fees in GRT. So indexers are the one, like just like to make it more intuitive. Imagine in client server architecture of Web2. The person who can run a server could be an indexer in the graph. So in graph, you have like almost more than 100 indexers, and this is a market of peer-to-peer indexer. Like if you are not liking any indexer, properly indexing your subgraph, you can just change your indexer, or like go for other indexer who provides a better pricing for the data you want to like get for your front end or get for your back. And then we have the curator. Curator curates signals the subgraph, which directly tells the indexer to come on board that this subgraph is legit and you should index over it. And then we have the delegator. It's a non-technical part, but very crucial. It helps to support the indexer to index the subgraph. And then a developer like me, you can just simply install the subgraph and pay for your data. It's the graph network is like a open B2B market of data out there. So yeah. So like now one of our core dev team of within the graph network named Semiotic is like working more into the AI part, integrating to AI part. As the world moves more towards the on-chain, this part becomes very crucial. So they have built a language named Agora. It's a domain-specific language. For example, if an indexer, if you approach an indexer to index a subgraph, like he must be demanding some kind of query fees. So it's like very important to have proper pricing model so that your customer can feel satisfied that he is getting the right data at the right price. So they have created this domain-specific language Agora, which helps to just simply tell the people like this is the right pricing for the query you want to get based on your query shape. So now the AI part comes. So Semiotic is doing more R&D to make it more accessible towards other subgraph also. So the Agora the Agora language can work only on one subgraph, and like implementing on other subgraph would be a very tedious part. So here comes that auto Agora. So it's the AI powered Agora, and it helps to like move towards other subgraphs. Yeah. So now let's again comes that LLM part. So LLM trained on the verifiable data, like again. So if you can just train the LLM over the DeFi data, many applications could come forward. Risk management, asset management, DAO. You can just find out the malicious play within the DAO. Helps in governance, developer tooling, analytics, and like a lot more things you can imagine right now with this part. And then like the best part, what I like in this part is matching queries with the right subgraph. So imagine you are a customer or the developer who wants to fetch the data from the network. So like the AI part helps you find the right subgraph for your like for your demand, for your dApp or for your startups. So yeah. So like this was pretty much about the Web3 data, AI, and the graph. So like I'm representing the Graph India community, and this from the last year in the month of June I started the community, and till now we have completed 22 events, like telling and availing people more about open, permissionless Web3 data. Why data like is important to you and as a humanity? Why it should be permissionless? So like the Web2 giant, if you have seen the Web2 giants have been like built on the Web2 data and on your data, ours data. So it's crucial to educate the community out there. And like it's the a small overview about the Graph India community. So, and it's more specifically about like builders in India. So like many projects have come from Indian community, like name Polygon, Bicami, InstaDApp, and Shardium. So a lot more coming too. And in our ecosystem, we have already 40 supported chains and more than 5 plus supported on the decentralization. So this was pretty much about the Web3 AI and the Graph. The Graph India, which the community I'm building. And thank you so much for attending this. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask. And if you want to go into more in depth conversation, just text me the Telegram.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Do we have any questions? Comments?
Yes.
What about scaling the graph? Is going better than you expected, and what about it is going worse than you expected?
So, the best part I like about scaling, getting the process of scaling in context of graph is like we have an army of business developer out there, and army of like. There are many integration engineers. So our focus is more on getting more and more supported networks over our chain. And right now, we are in the sunrise phase. We are stopping the hosted service and getting those network into our decentralized network. And coming to the second question, the worst part. So yeah, like right now we are like focusing on like reducing the query fees. It's like a lot more. Because the RPC, running RPC cost in Asia is more, and like that's how we are not able to get more indexer from Asia. So that's the pain point of ours. But yeah, like this was pretty much about it.
Thank you. Does that answer your question? Sorry, great question. I have only one question for you, because we're a little bit running short on time. Coming back to our title, Open Information, what do you think that is Open Information or Open Web 2?
Yeah, so I think this is the most crucial question now out there for this event. Like, the Open Information like simply means to me as a person, it's like you are getting the right information. So in Web 2, there is abundance of information. You cannot understand or you cannot verify its authenticity, verifiability, but the property of blockchain, that track and traceability, allows it to find the source of the information. So even in Web3, you can still not say the information is authentic, but you can identify from where the source of the information is. Having certain level of credibility from the source, you can identify that that information is right or is like correct.
Right, totally agree. Well said. So, thank you again. Thank you, Charchit. Thank you, guys.
Thanks for having me.